back in the land down under, back on the ponies. Ugh, flies are bad. Sprayed her, but I didn't spray myself. Typical. Oh, God, they're just terrible. I hate summer in Australia so much. Anyway, excuse me. I'm just going to do the Aussie wave. So I'm back riding the horses, which I'm very excited about. I have been back just over a week and I had to get the horses' shoes put back on because they took their shoes off while I was away. And yeah, they've been going really well. I've had, this will be my third or fourth ride back on Missy Mare. And I've had one ride on Jackson. It's so funny. You can really tell the difference between a sort of semi-educated horse like Mare and a real green bean like Jacko. Mare was just straight back on the ball, straight back into it. No real dramas, maybe a tiny little bit of fitness lost in the sort of 3 weeks that I didn't ride her. But yeah, poor old Jacko, he was like, I don't remember any of this. I don't think I can canter. But he'll get back into it. I actually have to step up a little bit, be a little bit more consistent with my riding on him. I probably only ride him maybe 3 days a week before I went away. But I'm gonna have to be a little bit more consistent with him because I picked out a show for him in November and it's actually kind of a big show at the State Equestrian Centre. He is just doing the intermediate hacks, so just the beginner hacks at the show, but it's more just gonna be the environment that is a little bit bigger than anything he's experienced yet. So hopefully I'll be able to take him off property a little bit and give him a bit more preparation for this show because he was probably a touch underdone at his last show. So hopefully we'll do some off property schooling days and I will be able to vlog them. Missy Mare's going well. There is hopefully a dressage day that I'm going to take her to at the end of the month, which would be awesome. And yeah, so I'm going to put my phone away and actually do some work. Mum said she would come out and video a bit of my rides today, so that's what we're going to do. Ah, flies. So Missy was actually a little bit tight and didn't work her very best today, but the thing that I'm most pleased with her is that her not quite best is actually still pretty good and very rideable now. I just felt like I couldn't really get her to engage and soften over her back as much as she has been, but yeah, her work is still pretty reliable and pretty good now, so I'm quite pleased with her. Thank you.
Do they not have horses riding on their lawns?
That's one of the things.
That's a big one.
The other thing is, their lawns are much smaller.
What are you talking about? They don't have 50 by 50 lawns?
No.
Oh, that's weird.
They spend lots of money on them.
Oh, so
from what I can tell, that seems to be the three
important big ones.
Really,
so
massive area.
Yeah.
But I still feel, Karen, like we're going to get the riding paddock over summer to a point where we can play croquet on it.
There is a croquet club in Mandurah. I drove past it when I saw Laura yesterday.
So I was actually so pleased with how Jackson worked today. He was very consistent and light and soft and obedient. I was rapt with him. He is getting quite good at staying soft in a bit of a lower outline, which I like him to do at the moment. And I think that he's almost ready to go to the next stage where I sort of short my reins and half halt him and put him together a bit. So that's very exciting. I was really rapt with today's ride.
It'll look great.
But we're not doing Hunter anymore, so.
Well, I wanted to do the working Hunter on George.
Yeah. I still think we should have two height classes.
Definitely. Oh, look at that. He just trotted over it.
He is a professional cross-rail boy now.
He sure is.
I taught him to jump that one time.
No, I think it's been twice. Don't be hard on yourself, Nards. I swear it was twice.
He seems to more have the idea that he's supposed to go. I'll pull it down and put in chariots. What is it?
Chariots of Fire.
Okay.
Dun, 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 dun. That's magnificent.
So I realized when editing this video that I left her bib completely messed up under her rug. But I'm sure she will forgive me for it and I will fix it in the morning. So I actually, when I was on holiday, really missed making my little horsey videos, and I definitely missed the ponies while I was in Europe. Karen did such a great job of looking after them for me, so I'm really grateful about that. I have been thinking I might try and make my YouTube videos a little more routine. Try and find a day every week that I upload. So I hope you enjoyed this video and we'll come back next time to watch another one. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye.